Nyanibingelela nonke emakhaya ngithande futhi ukunamukela ku-Rise. Namhlanje sikhuluma ngezifo ezitholakala ngokocansi futhi nokusebenzisa kahle ijazi. Ninjani bafethu?
Siyaphila.
Hayi ngathi philanga ngiyazi.
Hayi, ngiphakela.
Ngithanda ukubuza ukuthi kungani singasebenzisi vele ijazi?
As in, abantu abaningi bacabanga ukuthi musebenzisa ijazi it doesn't feel the same as when ulisebenzisa.
Eqiniso futhi lelo ukuthi abantu bayacabanga ukuthi kunjalo. Kodwa sinye futhi sizathu sinaso ukuthi amantombazane uma kuwukuthi thina sisebenzisa ama contraceptives simale siyekele ukusebenzisa ama condom ngenxa yokuthi sisabukhulelwa ngaphambi kokuthi sisabe oyingculazi.
Yeah.
And enye into engiyibonile ukuthi masozwana nomuntu isikhathe sithi ayasho ukuthi hayi umuntu wami uhayimele ngisebenzisa i condom umuntu wami.
Hayi kodwa bafethu mina yazi ngilisebenzisa njalo nje ijazi and mina ngicabanga ukuthi ayikho difference kule nto yazi.
I think it's two things that happen during that condom negotiation. Mm-hmm. So the first part is easy, fine. You can find a sexy way to wear the condoms. Who's buying condoms? Mm-hmm. Ne? Mm-hmm. When you're in the heat of the moment, it's something completely different. So you know the condom there, you've spoken about it, you've had that negotiation. Mara condom hayo. So
manje iphuma nini? Siphi isikhathi esirayithi? Iphuma nini le condom?
Yazi angifuni ukuhambela amanga yasi. Singathi isiphi isikhathi esirayithi. Kodwa ngokwazi kwethu, sijwayele ukhipha icondom uma sekushisa ngaphakathi embedeni.
Mina ngithanda ukuthi iphume before siqale nokubambana. Ngoba masiqalile, hayi angikwazi ukuthi ngicabange icondom.
Kanjani
icondom kanjani? Futhi yazi umuntu wami manje sesiqala igame nyana yabo. Yesifihla ama condom everywhere endlini. Kuthi mefuna ukuthi yabo siqale manje uyakhipha nje imilanga ukhipha phansi kwensipho bafethu.
Sibambeni ke lapho asibheke nomthandazi ukuthi sisifundisa kanjani ngale ndaba ye condom since sihlupha kangaka.
Before I was more educated on the condom usage, I didn't see the need of using a condom. It was like it didn't even exist. But there was a time where bengibele ngifunda about HIV, how it affects abantu, and bengibona my peers falling pregnant, having to drop out ukuze bakhulise abantwana yabona, and bangakhona ukubaya esikolweni. So there came a time where I decided that I need to use the condom in my relationship. I like working with young people in the old world, especially girls. What I discovered is that young people are mostly concerned about not falling pregnant rather than getting STIs and HIV. So the main use of condom Google is just preventing pregnancy, and that's it.
It's fine, but when I abstain, which is a very good thing, I guess. But at the same time, akumelanga sithene a blind eye ukuthi some of us are already sexually active, angithi. So ukuze ungatholi iSTI, ukuze ungatholi HIV, ukuze ungatholi ungabi pregnant, ungaplenanga ne and usase teenager, yini into ekumele uyisebenzise? Icondom, ne?
Into e-right nokuthi sinomthandazo azokhuluma ngale zinto lezi ukuthi sina siyasaba like ukukhuluma nabantu abadala anyeke sikhona ukuphendula emaklasini if abo members sibuza about pregnancy or i-sex. Maye usinomthandazo mncane uyathi like simbona ngathi ulingana nathi siyakhona ukukhuluma naye sikhulume sikhona siveza ama-opinion wethu.
I-condom ma uyisebenzisa is it 100% ukuthi angeke uze uthole i-HIV or ama-STIs na?
It's not 100% cause yet if I are gonna be out eshaya into ende and so since it's so have a sex inga plaster noma kunini
100% cause it depend on ukuthi when uyifake right na if ungayifaka nga right vele izobust mara if uyifake right anyaki past.
So how do we use the male condom?
Uyivula kanje.
Okay. Uyivula ngamazinyo. Oh, all right.
Ngicabanga ukuthi uJP yonke into ayenzile uyenze sharp yabo.
Yeah.
But icondom makayivula kayivulanga sharp icala.
Uh-huh.
You should also know ukuthi icondom is not there to decrease intimacy. It is there to protect you from falling pregnant, getting STIs and HIV, you know. So the most important thing is using it, because if you use it right, then you won't have to worry about other things.
So enye into engikhathazayo ukuthi why thina abantu besifazane masothenga ama-condom estore kuba into embi. Why?
Well, yes, ngokwazi kwami ukuthi siqanjwa amagama abambe. Amabi amagama a njenge slut, you know, sexually forward, yeah. Or besibize ngokuthi si loose. So la magama lawa asiphatha kabi ngaphakathi ngoba asizona lezo zinto abasichazayo.
You know, the first time I chatted by condoms. It was actually very recently. I drove to the garage. I got in there and then there was a couple of guys I knew. I was like, nope, got back in my car, drove to the next garage, right? So I told my wife to go for a ride. Hello, I'm excited. Condoms. But I'm whispering, what condoms? I'm like, yeah. Which size? I'm like, and it was really embarrassing. And I don't even understand why it was so embarrassing. Because I mean, it's supposed to be normal. Yeah. Like, I get a condom, but it was the most dramatic experience.
Yeah, I can imagine.
But guys, are we going to get infected just because of the stigma? I think we must start carrying condoms around. Hey, it's not worth it.
And the thing is, when you buy condoms, but to wash over snacks, but not a pregnant, but to wash over snacks. Yeah. Not cool, but to wash over snacks. So pick your battle at the end of the day, you know.
For your health reasons, 7 condom, mara asibambeni lapho. Masibuya wozani zobona ukuthi ifaka kanjani condom.
Best thing about the female condom is it's not made out of latex, and this plastic is very soft. And as you're actually having sex, it warms up, so it gives you extra sensation as well.
Sani Bonani Ekaya. Our guest is Sara Chitambo, an advocacy manager for the prevention of HIV. Let's give her a warm rise welcome. Thank you, Sara, for joining us today. It's so good to have you here.
Thanks for having me in the studio.
So, Sara, we have two genital molds in front of us, right? Can you give us demonstrations on the do's and don'ts on correct condom use?
Absolutely. So in terms of correct condom use, let's start with the female condom.
Yeah.
This is what it looks like. And before you even start looking at it to open it, you have to first check the expiry date, which is usually in the sleeve over there.
Okay.
So this one's good. This one only expires in 2 years, so we're good with this
one. Okay, so we're good.
And just make sure that it's out of the way of your nails when you want to open it, and you literally just have to slide it down and it opens very easily. It's actually not finicky plastic at all, so it's very easy to open. And this is what it looks like when it's opened up. Okay, and to insert it, you just have to squeeze the ring like that, almost into the shape of a tampon or the shape of the number 8.
Okay.
And then before you insert it, you'd actually put your foot on a toilet seat or just elevate it slightly, or you can lie down or squat. You know, it's just like inserting a tampon.
Okay.
And when you want to insert it, you want to push it towards the small of your back. Okay, so it's quite lubricated. It will go in, it will slide quite easily. And when you're having sex, obviously you're quite wet, you're quite lubricated, so it's quite fine. Once it's at the base of your back, it actually touching the wall of your cervix, so it actually has a double function. Not only does it keep it locked in, but also during penetration, when the penis is hitting up against the wall of the cervix, the hard plastic is also quite stimulating. So once it's inserted and you've left the outside here, it's actually protecting the lips of your vagina as well, so that the base of the penis, if it has anything coming from the guy, doesn't enter you. So that's the female condom.
But Sara, I've often heard that you must put it in a few hours before. Is that true?
No, absolutely not. It's not necessary anymore, and this can actually be quite a nice playful thing to do just before, in terms of foreplay, you know, because as he inserts it, it's quite pleasurable for you as well. So there's no need to insert it 6 hours earlier like we used to with the old design. They've improved the design. The best thing about the female condom is it's not made out of latex. Mm-hmm. It's made out of polyurethane plastic, which is for anybody who's allergic to latex, you don't react to it. So that's a good thing as well.
Okay.
And this plastic is very soft.
Mm-hmm.
And as you're actually having sex, it warms up, so it gives you extra sensation as well.
Nice.
So there's quite a few there's quite a lot of benefits to the female condom.
And how do you discard it after you've used it?
You would turn it so that nothing leaks. You have to make sure that nothing leaks and that you don't come into contact with anything.
Okay.
You would pull it out and you would put it in a tissue paper and throw it out in a dustbin. Please do not flush it down the toilet. So that's the way you get rid of it.
Okay, great.
So then the other one that we have here is the male condom, which is obviously the more popular and the more widely available option of condoms.
Yeah.
And the one thing you want to remember about the male condom, just like the female condom, you want to spread the lubricant around before you open. And you also want to check the expiry date, just as we did with the female condom. Now, once you take out the male condom out of the holder, the plastic, you have to make sure that it's out the right way around.
Yeah, okay? What's the right way?
Because the right way around is going to allow you to slide down very easily. Mm-hmm. So that's the wrong way around, and this is the right way around. So the right way around will allow you to put it on quite smoothly. You touch that to let the air out, mm-hmm. and it will roll down quite easily because that's how it's meant to go, okay? And you make sure that you slide it down all the way down to the base of the penis, mm-hmm. where it will hold in place. So that's the male condom.
How do you make it fun to use a condom? Mm. Because sometimes you're like, maybe it's not so fun anymore.
I think condoms are very underrated. There's a lot of things that you can do with condoms in terms of foreplay. They come in flavors, so there's beautiful scents that get spread in the room. You can get textured condoms, you can get rib condoms, you know, just the texture. And there's also tingling sensations, there's some that have tingling sensations. And I know that there are ranges that where you get condoms that actually vibrate as well. So there is a lot of fun that you can have in terms of protecting yourself with condoms.
Okay, so can you use the male and female condom together at the same time?
Absolutely not. Absolutely not.
Okay.
Because what happens if you take these two pieces of plastic mm-hmm. and they cause friction? So inevitably, you're basically cancelling them out. You're cancelling mm-hmm. each other out. So you must not use both of them at the same time. Use either the male condom or the female condom, and they're both protecting you against HIV and unwanted pregnancy.
Can you explain what an STI is? Mm.
An STI is an infection that gets passed on from one person to another during sexual contact. And some don't actually even need sexual contact. It can just be touching of skin or the touching of the genitals. So it's very dangerous because you don't always necessarily, you can't tell just by looking that you have an STI.
So how would I know if I had an STI?
The most dangerous thing, like I said, is that it takes a while sometimes before you can even feel any symptoms.
Yeah.
Okay, but some of the visible symptoms are a discharge from the vagina or from the penis or from the anus as well. You can have sores and bumps and rushes as well that can manifest themselves. But the most dangerous thing about STIs is that they don't always manifest physically.
What are the most common types of STIs that we can find around?
Some common STIs are, for example, chlamydia, mm-hmm. which is a discharge, or can also be called a drip when men have it. And another one is HPV. And actually what is happening is the government is also doing HPV vaccines for primary school girls so that they can, you know, not get it later in life. And what's very dangerous about HPV is if it's left untreated, it can cause cervical cancer.
Yeah,
you know,
that's scary.
Yeah, so HPV and chlamydia are some of the most common ones amongst young women.
Okay, so these STIs, can I treat any of them at home if I think I have one or if I find out I have one?
Never, absolutely not.
Okay.
You have to go to a clinic, you have to go to a doctor, you have to go to a hospital and make sure that you take the prescribed antibiotics and finish them, because the last thing you want is for it to keep recurring, okay? Mm-hmm. So don't try to treat it yourself. Go and get proper medication and finish the medication so that you can cure it.
As young people, you know, we're scared more of pregnancy than we are of STIs. Mm-hmm. So can you tell me, is it as easy as just popping a pill a day and getting rid of the STI, or is it more complicated than that?
It's a little bit more complicated. As much as STIs are simple infections, because we don't always necessarily pick up the symptoms early enough, they may have already been and affected our body. So it's important to prevent them, number one, by using condoms consistently, correctly. Mm-hmm. And when you can, actually try to use both a condom as well as a contraceptive method such as a hormonal pill, okay?
Yeah.
So the most important thing we want to say is try to prevent it, and it's not that easy to get rid of, so you want to not get it in the first place.
Before you came, we asked our audience if they had any questions, so this is what they had to ask. So number one, can you be allergic to condoms, and what is the alternative if you are?
Yes, there are people who can be allergic to latex, and if it truly you are allergic to latex, as some people might be, the good option, a good alternative, is to use the female condom, which is not made out of latex.
Okay, some good options there. Yeah. So number two is it possible that a condom can be too big or too small?
Condoms are a standard issue, okay? Mm. So we have a regular size in condoms, which is supposed to fit snugly mm-hmm. onto any size penis. There are, on a commercial level, I know that you can get extra large, but those are outliers. Those are people who fall outside the norm.
Special okay? cases.
Yes. So, but most condoms are made to fit so that they stretch or so that they can fit snugly on any size penis. So.
Thank you so much, Sara, for joining us today. And I'm definitely going to start negotiating better in the bedroom. When we come back, we'll find out what's in our toolbox. Stay tuned.
Which of the following STIs is not curable? Karabo ki B. Herpes ke yona STI e senang phekolo. Jole he se le nako e yane neng mo re tlotlang le Mam Lebo le our Rise Young Woman. Mam Lebo le kae?
Re teng le kae ausi.
Re teng as always. It's always such a pleasure to have you here. Ladies, are you good? Fetlong ka potso tse pedi a rutle na what our young women think. Hona le motho a tshwereng potso.
Okay.
Mna benifuna ukwazi bangaba xa ngaba ukuthiwa uyile clinic kwafumanisa ukubonayo STI wayinika treatment wayigqiba futhi ngexesha ekumele uyiqibe ngakhona. Then after that uthi uphinde ufumanise ba usatholakala ukuthi la apha ku private part yakho kusele nabo ba itchinyana ngithe ezinye kuke kuthiwa i symptoms zakhona kuba itching ngaphansi. So ngifuna ukwazi mangabe xa usoyiqiba i treatment ufumana leyo symptom again ukwenza ube kwenzekeleni.
When une STI ne, the most important thing, there are two important things. If uya kwi clinic, it's very good ufumane i treatment, but it's also good that you tell i partner yakho ukubana you have had i STI ngoba ukuba wena uthathe i treatment yena angayithathi, you know, akuncedi. We understand. So it's also important that you go. We have a partner work, but no, bendile at clinic, kuthiwa ndine sexually transmitted infection. Ukuba naye ayithathe infection yakhe. Okay? Because there's a possibility of bana you will be reinfected if you are having sex with your partner. But it's also very important that either we are linda, you abstain from sex, ukubana naye afumane a treatment, you are both treated. But also very, very important that you use condoms, even mhlawumbe after a treatment. So the cause could be you've had sex, uthathe treatment, but u continue uku have sex with your partner who's also not treated, okay? Or you have sex without condoms and you get another infection.
Mina, my question is based on female condom. Mm-hmm. I heard you see Sara Ayla saying, Guti, now you don't have to wait six hours or whatever time that was said, would you have to wait before you use a condom. So I see Guti, she's still using the same method, how you insert it. But why not now? You can't wait for that period today.
Okay. So it's not that you can't wait, but it's not necessary for you to wait. Because material, as she said, that the new condoms have been made for. And as they make condoms, they improve on them. So these new ones, bazenze nge material yokuthi, you don't necessarily have to ukubana ihlale kuwe for a long time. However, if ufuna kuye bumnandini, you don't want to be talking a lot, negotiating condoms and all of that, you can still uifake and aizokulimaza. There's nothing wrong ezoyenza ngaphakathi. But even if it's like in the act and ufuna kuyifaka, don't worry about that time that you have to ukuthi you've got to wait, etc. You can faka sebenzisa. Yes.
Mam Lebo, parting words for us as young women.
Well, I'm so excited that you are discussing condoms. Mm. I wish in my time when I was having sex they were flavored and they are strawberry and grape and stuff like that. Mm. I think condoms are about eroticizing safer sex. What I mean by that is that condoms should be about making sex enjoyable.
Of course.
They should not be yes. about a burden, you know? So get glow in the dark, chase each other in the dark where you just see the pennies flicking, you know? You don't have to see the person, just see the pennies.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Get flavors, grape, strawberry, raspberry, whatever.
Definitely.
Make
yes.
them part of the fun. rather than this thing, you know. For us, what is important is that you have safe, enjoyable sex, okay? Because you are going to have sex. Even if we asked you to wait until you were 30, if you don't know how to negotiate safer sex, if you don't know how to use condoms, even older people in their marriages, even if you did all the right things according to society, you waited, you got married, you were never a sinner, you were in church every day, you did everything right, and then you are supposed to have sex. We are living in a time and an age of HIV. So even if you did all the right things, so I'm not trying to say anything about anything, I'm saying even if you lived and did everything correct, at the time you have sex, even if it's at 45, you must be able to negotiate safer sex and be able to make it enjoyable. So have fun, strawberry, raspberry, chocolate, whatever. Just
definitely
have fun.
Thank you so much for that, Mam Lebu. Ladies, thank you so much for your amazing questions. Guys, we've learned so much. I don't even know where to start. I mean, personally, just talking about sex, for me, that was groundbreaking. That broke some barriers down.
Mina ngokwami, ngibona ukuthi uma uthole igciwane, akululi ukuthi ulapheke. It's not just as simple as, you know, popping a pill and then you think that you're going to be cured the next day, you know. It extends. So sekuyisikhathi sokuthi sithathe isinqumo sokuthi sisebenzise ama condom so that we can live healthy sexual lifestyles.
Oh yes, definitely. What an amazing show. Hare Lebu, Mam Lebu, our Rise audience, my darling co-host, and of course every single one of you at home. O seke wa lebala go gotla gape beke e tlang, ga tla bo re bua taba tse dingwe tse botlhokwa tse re amang. O re tshware ka motato ho Mixed Reach ga mmogo le ho Facebook. Hi Weborok.
Woof, woof.